Good afternoon, dear students. Today we are going to study our 12th lesson, The Siege of Purandar and the Treaty with Mughal Emperor. In this lesson, we are going to study the points: Raid on Surat, Siege of Purandar by the Mughal Army, Murar Baji, Incomparable Valor, Treaty of Purandar. So, students, let's start with our lesson. Raid on Surat. After this attempt, Shivaji did not sit idle. Aurangzeb's troops were laying waste the whole of Maharashtra. To bring the emperor to his senses, Shivaji carried out his daring raid on Surat. Surat was so far away from Pune that no one but Shivaji could have thought to do this daring raid. Surat was then in a great center of trade in the Mughal Empire and a very rich city. Shivaji carried out the raid successfully and brought him home a boot worth lakh of rupees. Shivaji did not forsake and raid on Surat. He spread the churches and mosques. He did not show disrespect to women. The raid on Surat drew Aurangzeb into a furious rage. He now decided to put an end to Maratha kingdom. He ordered his great general Mirza Raje Jai Singh to humble Shivaji. To assist Mirza Raje in the campaigning, he sent with him his trusted Sardar Dilair Khan. The two landed into Deccan with a huge army and unlimited funds. Swaraj was in real danger. Immediately after his return from the expedition of Surat in 1664 AD, Shivaji Maharaj heard a sad news. Shahaji Raje suffered an accidental death while on hunt. Shivaji and Jijabai were gently grieved. Holding his mother close to his bosom, Shivaji Maharaj consoled her. Siege of Purandar by the Mughal army. Purandar was one of Shivaji's big and strong forts. Dilair Khan knew that Shivaji could not be defeated as long as he was master of Purandar. He therefore laid siege to this powerful fort. He had a huge army under his command. Murar Baji was in charge of the fort. He was a determined fighter who would not easily yield to threat. He was also supported by brave troops. With their help, Murar Baji decided to defeat the fort. Dilair Khan's guns went into action. Firing cannons, balls began to drop on the fort. Murar Baji and his brave men held on. The first bastion of Machi collapsed under gunfire. Dilair Khan's troops captured the lower part. The Marathas withdrew their upper fort, continued the fight. Dilair Khan was watching the battle from his camp. The furious with rage, Murar Baji decided to attack the Mughal troops with a select contingent of 500 men. He opened the gate on the upper fort, shouting their war cry, "Har Har Mahadev!" The Mawlas fell on the Mughal troops after a furious battle which lasted for a last short time. The Marathas routed the huge Mughal army which fled towards Dilair Khan's camp. Murar Baji followed them into hot pursuit, which his troop, he entered the camp of Dilir Khan and routed the walk there. The enemy troop were in flight, and Marathas in pursuit. Cries, shout filled with the whole camp. The great hurry Dilir Khan mounted his elephant and looked ahead. There was Murar Baji hanging the soldiers into pieces. His sword moved like lightning, cut throats, broke the heads and pierced hearts of enemy. No one could stop him or hold him in a check. Dilir Khan watched in admiring his great deed of bravery. Murar Baji, incomparable valor. Seeing Dilir Khan, Murar Baji asked his troop to attack in full force and himself advanced towards Dilir Khan's. Whoever tried to obstruct him was cut to pieces. The Mughal troop at last surrendered Murar Baji on all sides. Just then Dilir Khan shouted, "Wait! Hold back your swords!" The Mughal troops held and moved back a little. Then Dilir Khan addressed Murar Baji, "Until now I have not seen a swordman like you. You come over to our side, I promise you complete safety. The emperor will make you a sardar and reward you with a jagir." His eyes red with the anger, Murar Baji said in return, We are the loyal servant of Shivaji Maharaj. Who wants to buy safety from you? Why should we come over to your side? And who wants your emperor jagir?" He then moved forward in the direction of Dilir Khan and again started attacking his soldiers. Dilir Khan was now seated in the head and the elephant back, released an arrow which pierced Murar Baji's neck. Murar Baji fell to the ground. His follower lifted his dead body and hit it back to the upper fort. "What if one Murar Baji is fallen? We too are brave like him. We will fight with courage." So, saying so, they began to fight again without losing heart. Shivaji heard the news. With a great sorrow, he knew that he could hold each one of his fort against the Mughal army. For a last more than a year, but he was unwillingly to do so at the cost of his men, who would die in the attempt. Treaty of Purandar. What could be done? He was not strong enough to fight the powerful Mughals. All his political skill was also no avail. There was only one thing he could do. He decided on a temporary withdrawal from the fight. He would enter into a treaty with the Mughal emperor. He went and saw Jai Singh. This was a very sensible and statesman-like thing to do. He said to Jai Singh, "Mirza Raji, you are a Rajput. You can understand our suffering. The emperor's campaigning have led to country waste and people are in a great misery. I have undertaken this task of establishing Swaraj so that the people may be happy. You should join me in appealing the task. If you agree to lead us myself and my Mawlas will your trusted followers. Jai Singh was not diplomatic. He pressured Shivaji to sign a treaty of peace with Emperor. Shivaji signed the treaty of according to his terms, 23 forts and 3 territory with a revenue of 4 lakh horns, means gold coins, were handed over to Mughal Emperor. The Treaty of Purandar was signed in 1665. After the treaty was signed, Jai Singh suggested to Shivaji that he should go to Agra and see Emperor. He also guaranteed Shivaji's safe return. Shivaji thought over the suggestion. He knew that the Emperor could not be trusted. He had proved treacherous to his own brothers. But in the end, Shivaji decided to take risk and face the situation and consciously as he could, informed Jai Singh that he was willing to go Agra to meet Emperor. Hope student, you understood lesson well. I'm going to give question answers in my next video. Thank you.